this video is not a regular album review, and it's not just here to critique or dispute someone else's album review. There's a new mixtape out from Little B, free to download, called Black Ken. And I was astonished, really genuinely astonished, at the negative review given to it by Anthony Fantano. Anthony Fantano is a very well-known and vegan music critic here on YouTube. And for me, the review from Anthony Fantano is so bad, it's so awful, it's so misguided and so misleading, that it really makes me question the role of music criticism in the 21st century, the role of music criticism in an era when you can download this stuff and hear it for free in 5 seconds at no effort to yourself. Little B, this is not piracy we're talking about. Little B is intentionally providing you with this music for free. And I wanted to provide some reflections on that, along with reflections on Little B's album, maybe a little bit about what Little B's music has meant to me over the years. Because I am a rap aficionado. Rap is 90% of the music I listen to, has been for many, many years. And of course, that's not true of Anthony Fantano. For him, it's only one of many genres he listens to, so he's at a little bit of a disadvantage here. I don't know how well he knows Little B's oeuvre, but that's, look, let's not get sidetracked. Back in the day, people used to pay $20 cash for a CD. I'm Canadian, starting with $20. And it was routine for albums, whether it's $15.99 or $20 where you live, it was routine for a pop album to have two good tracks on it. One single, maybe one other good track to back it up, and then maybe if you're lucky, 7 to 12 tracks of filler, of pretty low quality stuff, and that was a hit album, an album with two decent tracks, and you could pay $20 for it. All right, so-called classic rap albums, tons of them really have about four great tracks on them, okay? And it blows my mind that we've now got Anthony Fantano in such a contemptuous way dismissing this album from Little B, giving it 5 out of 10, when he admits repeatedly in the course of his review that it has multiple, he doesn't give a specific number, but it has several, a significant number of really good tracks that he himself would like to listen to again that will stick around in his hard drive or whatever. Okay? So we're living in an era when I've got to say this whole concept of rating an album from 1 to 10 has become meaningless. Because you can download an album for free in seconds, right? Therefore, by definition, every album is either a 0 or a 10. Either an album is worthwhile for you to download or it is not. Now, before doing this review, before recording this video, I checked. An album that's considered an all-time classic from Little B is the God's Father mixtape. Okay? So this is broadly praised by music critics, by rap fans, what have you. And I believe from the God's Father mixtape on my hard drive today, I have 14 tracks. Okay? The album had like more than 30 tracks on it. And 14 survived. So what do you think? If I'm reviewing that album, a free mixtape, free to download, do you think I'm going to say it's garbage because more than 50% of the tracks got deleted? That kind of critical lens does not make sense anymore. Now, Lil B is an extreme case of this where he is not his own editor. He goes to the studio, he records a bunch of tracks day in, day out, and then he puts out the whole stack of music he's recorded for his fans for free. And he leaves it up to you to pick and choose what you're going to delete off your hard drive. So yes, it is a little bit, I mean, if you had come out of a time machine from the 1960s and you were used to highly polished, highly professional concept albums where every track is closely related to the title of the album, you know what I mean? If you had grown up just listening to the Beatles, you know, Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, this kind of concept album where every track is part of a clear progression from beginning to end, all with a super high recording budget, there's nothing extraneous, there are no bonus tracks, you know what I'm saying? Then yeah, it might come to you as a shock that this new mixtape from Little B, it has 27 tracks, and if you listen to them through, you're probably going to delete the majority of them, even if you're a Little B fan. But this critical lens, there are two critical lenses here that make no sense. Look, this album, it's a 10. Do you know why? Right now I can name two songs on it that are great. Not just good, but great. I'd say Still Run It and The Real Is Back. Those are two albums. Those are two tracks on the album that are great. And then beyond that, I don't have to nickel and dime every track here because it's all free music. So if I'm talking to a friend or even if I'm doing a formal review, I can say, look, there are enough really outstanding tracks here to justify your time downloading the album, listening through, and then deciding for yourself, skip around, fast forward back and forth, which tracks you're going to delete and which you're going to keep out of the 27 on offer here, right? Now, another thing that, you know, kind of blows my mind, all music criticism is biased in favor of experimental music. And yet Little B still managed to get a 5 out of 10 out of this guy. This is Anthony Fantano. This is the same guy who gave The Death Grips a 10 out of 10. Okay? Death Grips are as experimental as hip-hop gets. There's no way you can say that Lil B's lyrical content is garbage or Lil B's lyrical delivery is weak relative to The Death Grips. I'm sorry, Anthony Fantano, but you don't have a leg to stand on. For sure, there are critics, there are voices within hip-hop who maybe come out of a very traditional, old-school, you know, they just straight-up worship Ghostface and nothing else. Ghostface is new school, technically. But, you know, where anything that doesn't live up to a certain particular standard of lyrical delivery and format is not going to get a high grade out of them. But Anthony Fantano, you rewarded the garbage lyrical content, the worse than mumble rap, incoherent covering up of totally inept rapping by the Death Grips. You rewarded that with a 10 out of 10. All right, and that music does not hold up today, like most experimental music. Death Grips had a track, I've Seen Footage. It was a fresh new sound. It was experimental. It was different. The lyrical content is non-existent. The quality of the rap delivery is zero. But at that time, sure, it was something new, something different, something edgy. He gave that a 10 out of 10. This new album from Lil B is experimental. And it's worthwhile pausing to think on what do we mean by an experiment. An experiment, by definition, has an outcome that is unknown, has an outcome that is unpredictable. If we knew what the outcome would be, it would not be an experiment. And that's actually true in the hard sciences, and it's true in the arts also. That's the meaning of what it really is to be experimental. This album from Little B, you know, I couldn't believe it. Anthony Fantano says, like, the vocal delivery and the stuff from Lil B is the same as it always was. He makes some dismissive comments. It's completely untrue. Have you been listening, Lil B? This is a real creative departure. This is really innovative. This is really different musically and in terms of lyrical style. And it is reaching back to classic sounds from hip-hop from the period when gangster rap didn't yet really exist. Lil B is really reaching back to and evoking memories of guys like Schoolie D, real pioneers. And Lil B is intentionally staggering his vocal delivery and having these pauses that mimics, and even some of his choice of slang is out of date hip-hop slang to bring back the sense of that era. And he's playing his own keys. There's, in my opinion, a great musical intro. A lot of the keyboards are summoning up memories of Sega Genesis. Like, it sounds like cheap Yamaha bass out of a cheap synth from that era, you know, like 16-bit era. Great sound, really striking, really different, really experimental, really new. Look, man, this year, Raekwon put out an album. It didn't push any boundaries. There was absolutely nothing experimental and absolutely nothing new about it. I'm a huge Raekwon fan. If you asked me to do an all-time top five right now, I would name Raekwon as number one, okay? But Raekwon put out an album called The Wild. He put out a new album this year, and there was not a single track from it on my hard drive. I listened through each track maybe twice, and I deleted them all. Not a single track survived. And a whole bunch of tracks from this new album from Lil B are going to survive. And that Raekwon album, whether you liked it or not, you personally, subjectively may have gotten something out of it, there is nothing new, there is nothing innovative in it. Not musically, not lyrically, there's nothing provocative, there's nothing to think about, nothing to talk about, the new album from Raekwon. Just yesterday, I think, maybe the day before yesterday, I was on YouTube and I happened to get the alert, a new song from Snoop Dogg came out, okay? Like, it was like, oh, uploaded 10 minutes ago kind of thing. I was like, oh, okay, I'll give it a chance. Do you think Snoop Dogg has done anything innovative, progressive, new, experimental in the last 10 years? In the last 10 years, you can look at all these established rappers across the board and say in the last 10 years, even if they did something groundbreaking 20 years ago, which is probably true in Snoop Dogg's case. Snoop Dogg's very first album, sure, there was something new, there was something groundbreaking there. But look, man, in the last 10 years, who has done more for hip-hop, Lil B or Snoop Dogg? It's Lil B. That's really the sense in which Lil B, he's a tiny giant. He's this small outsider artist, and guys like Anthony Fantano can insult him, claiming that he has no lyrical skill. No lyrical skill compared to what? He has no lyrical skill compared to Death Grips? Death Grips, whom you gave 10 out of 10 to, Anthony Fantano? Please. You think Lil B has no lyrical content compared to Death Grips? Compared to Snoop Dogg? Compared to, I dare say it, Raekwon in the last 10 years? Lil B has had songs just talking about feeling sad. And I've got to say, like, lyrically, there's more depth and more substance to it than, like, 90% of what's going on in the genre. You know? Just songs about being unhappy. Okay? Just songs about being unhappy about what's happened to friends of his. And, you know, all kinds of really simple emotional tracks. I remember right after the birth of my daughter, I was in the hospital. You know, we didn't have a sound system in the hospital. I bought a pair of little mini portable speakers for my MP3 player, set it up, and I remember listening to the God's Father mixtape. Gold House had a list of, you know, maybe 5 mixtapes from Lil B that I was listening to while I was in the hospital, exhausted, sleep-deprived, dealing with all this abuse from the doctors and nurses. They were such assholes to us, to me and my ex-wife, you know. And, you know, really feeling that, you know, moody, reflective vibe, often very dissatisfied with life in various ways. You know, there's a lot of Lil B music that has emotional content. Does it have intellectual content? Not really. But, like, what in rap music does? What are we comparing it to? Are we comparing it to Death Grips? It gets a 10 out of 10. I'm sorry. Sorry to be stuck on it. But, like, you know, this is a really strange element because I think all music critics are positively biased in favor of experimental music. And that's why Death Grips were these kind of critical darlings, this kind of art house rap. And yet Lil B doesn't seem to get that bias working in his favor when he comes out with a really edgy, innovative album like Black Ken. That is an experimental album and deserves to be acclaimed as such, right? And then the other, I've talked about already, I think the rating system from 1 to 10 is now obsolete. Everything is either a 0 or a 10. Either you're willing to download it and give it a chance and pick out the tracks you're going to keep, or you're not. Either there are a couple of tracks there that justify the download, that justify your taking the time, because there's no cost, or there aren't. And to stick with that example, Raekwon's album, The Wild, is not worth your time, is not worth downloading. I did not keep even one track. Whereas I feel confident I can recommend this Lil B album to you and give it a 10 out of 10 because there are minimum 2 tracks. I think probably for a lot of people who like hip-hop or who like Lil B, minimum 6 tracks out of these 27 that you're going to keep. Does that mean every track is great? No. And some of them are maybe thought-provoking in terms of the composition, in terms of the keyboards, but don't follow through lyrically. But again, that's Lil B's choice. He doesn't give you a short list. He doesn't give you Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. He doesn't give you a careful composition. He gives you every single thing he banged out in the studio, everything swept up off the studio floor, and says, hey, maybe it's worth something to you, maybe it's not. That's how he sees the role of the recording artist. And that brings me to the last point I want to make here. There's this delusion, which Anthony Fantano was a complete victim of, that the value of music is in looking at the album as one unit, right? So, like, one of the most ridiculous examples of this was Ghostface put out 12 Reasons to Die, right? And all the music critics praised this way out of proportion. I'm sorry, Ghostface, 12 Reasons. It got all this praise from music critics just because it is a concept album and because supposedly, like, it tells one story. It holds together as one unit, right? Because music critics are still looking for Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. They're still looking for the album to be one aesthetic unit or statement, which it's never going to be for Lil B. With free mixtapes, I think it's never going to be, period. But, like, what are you really saying? You're saying you would have given this a higher score if it had half as many tracks and was twice as coherent as an artistic statement, right? Like, if the title of the album was thematically linked to each track, like Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, it's such bullshit, guys. It's such, I'm sorry, 12 Reasons from Ghostface. 12 Reasons is a mediocre album. I'm not going to say it's terrible. Some of the tracks sounded good when I heard them remixed by other artists. I don't think any of them really sounded good in the original album. But I have heard some remixes of a couple of tracks that hold up. But compared to Ghostface's other output, a real candidate for the greatest Ghostface album ever is titled More Fish. It was the sequel to another album that had Fish in the title. More Fish has no concept, no direction. You know what I mean? None of this cute bullshit. It was a bunch of tracks, some of which he recorded for mixtapes, some of which he recorded for albums, some of which were left over from other sessions, put together on one disc, you know, a bunch of different producers. That's the creative process. And it's one of the greatest albums in the history of rap music, history of hip-hop. But it doesn't have this thing that these music critics are looking for of being like one aesthetic unit, right? It's not a Sgt. Pepper's concept. So like within Ghostface's genre, something like 12 Reasons gets overrated, something like More Fish gets underrated, and somebody like Lil B is basically getting penalized because he isn't turning out albums that fit this unstated aesthetic expectation of what an album is supposed to be that's really left over from the 1960s and 1970s and never had a place in hip-hop, frankly, and definitely doesn't have a place in hip-hop now in the 21st century in the download era. All right, this video has gone on long enough or too long. Look, man, I've said this about romance also. A lot of guys walk around with this rating system in their head. Like, is a woman a 6, a 7, an 8, or a 9? You know, rating people out of 10, the same way people rate albums out of 10. But when I was giving advice on dating, I said, look, the bottom line is either you like someone enough to embarrass yourself, to go up to them, introduce yourself, hey, say what's going on. Either you like them enough to take that time, make that effort, take that risk, or you don't. So get rid of the numbers game. Don't let it mess up your head. Everybody is either a 0 or a 10. I think that's a lot mentally healthier for the guys. I'm not even saying that in like a feminist sense of like this is better to avoid objectifying women or something, right? And the reality is, when it comes to albums and album recommendations, we're no longer talking about money. We're just talking about time. This artist put together a 27-track artistic statement, you know, and it's free for you to download. It doesn't cost you a dime. So is it a 0 or a 10? The only judgment call I have to make is it worth your time to sift through this and pick out which tracks you are going to keep on your hard drive for free? It is. And music critics like Anthony Fantano are obsolete, out of touch. And the claims he makes that, like, on this album, Lil B is doing a bad impression, like his vocal style is doing a bad impersonation of Tupac. Fantano, you're way off. You're way off, both in terms of the keyboards and the lyrics. Anyone who knows hip-hop would recognize that Lil B is reaching way back to guys like Schoolie D and that earliest period of the antisocial persona coming into rap music, breaking away from rap as just party music, breaking away from rap as put your hands in the air, away from everyone's just don't care. Those very first voices where there wasn't yet gangster rap. And when there were a lot of these weird pauses. I mean, go back and listen to Schoolie D. That style of vocal delivery doesn't hold up today. A lot of that music, it was so inspiring. It was so new. It was so edgy at the time. And Lil B has referred to this as his first mixtape in that same sense. Instead of a sequel, it's a prequel. You know, he's going back to the roots of his genre of hip-hop. He's doing something new and different, but that in a really interesting way is reaching back to the musical origin of hip-hop. I don't know. I don't know in this day and age, when it's free to download, I don't know how you can give this album anything other than a 10. And you tell me, in the last decade, who's really done more for hip-hop as a genre? In the last decade, Lil B or Snoop Dogg? When we look back on this history, in this decade, who's done more for hip-hop? Lil B or Death Grips? The answer is going to be Lil B, not Death Grips.